Take a look at my number line here. In the center, you have zero. To the right, you have all the positive numbers, and to the left, you have all the negative numbers. Positive and negative numbers on the number line are called integers. And I'd like us to do some comparing of these numbers, keeping in mind that the one to the right is always larger. Think of your bank account having zero in it, and anything above zero is good. You've got money in your checking account. If you have anything in the negative, it means you're overdrawn. Now, here's the interesting thing that we sometimes forget. As the numbers appear to get larger as we go to the left with our negative numbers, they are in fact getting smaller. You're overdrawn by $1, but it's much worse to be overdrawn by $10. So the higher the numbers go, the smaller they get. So let's do some comparison with our inequality signs. Let's say I have a negative 2 is less than 0. Well, here's a negative 2 and here's 0. 0 is to the right, so negative 2 is less than 0. How about negative 7 is less than a negative 4? Here's a negative 4 on the number line, and you can see that it is to the right of the negative 7. So a negative 7 is less than a negative 4. Let's try, let's say 6 is greater than 0. 6 is to the right of 0, and 6 is greater than 0. Okay, let's try just a couple more. How about negative 1 is greater than negative 9? Negative 1 is to the right of negative 9. Some people also look and say, well, it's closer to 0. Well, that's nice on the negative side, but that doesn't really work on the right-hand side. So I always go with the number to the right of another number is larger. So a negative 1 is greater than a negative 9. All right, how about negative 4 is less than 2? Here's the 2 on the number line, and negative 4 is to the left, or 2 is to the right of a negative 4. So that's a true statement. Negative 4 is less than 2. All right. Now, let's also look at something called absolute value. Let me write that for you. Absolute value. A sample of it would look like this. Absolute value simply means how many jumps to get back to zero. So it's never negative. It's not negative jumps or positive jumps. It's just jumps back to zero. So if I were to give you this, if I were to say what is the absolute value of 5, I would go over to 5 and I would count how many jumps to get back to zero. I'm at 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's 5 jumps to get back to zero, so I bring it out of its absolute value signs, and the answer is 5. The absolute value of a negative 3 says, let's go to a negative 3 on the number line, right here, and how many jumps to get back to 0? 1, 2, 3. So the negative 3 comes out as a positive 3. So it doesn't matter if you have fractions or decimals or whole numbers, it always comes out positive. Let me give you some more examples. The absolute value of 1/2, it comes out as 1/2. The absolute value of negative 11, How many jumps back to zero from negative 11 will be 11? Bring it out of the absolute value bars. And maybe I have 4.2. Well, it's 4.2 jumps back to zero. So I'll bring it out of absolute value for 4.2. Absolute value is always, always, always going to be positive. There's a but coming, but we'll talk about that in a minute. All right. Now, let's compare some numbers when they're in absolute value. We've already been comparing numbers, just plain numbers. Now we're going to do it in absolute value. Let's say that we have an absolute value of a negative 7 is being compared to an absolute value of 5. You cannot compare numbers in absolute value till you bring them out of the absolute value bars. So I will bring the negative 7 out as a positive 7. And I'll bring the 5 out as a positive 5, because that's how many jumps back to 0. Now that I've brought them out of absolute value, 7 is greater than 5. And I'll put my greater than sign, or I could do my greater than, less, greater than, or equal to sign. Okay? Let's try another one. Let's say that I have 4.7. in absolute value, and I would like to compare it to a negative 4.3 in absolute value. Okay? It doesn't matter if it's positive or negative. It always is going to come out how? That's right, as a positive. So this comes out as 4.7. This comes out as 4.3. 4.7 is greater than 4.3. So we'll put our inequality sign in right there. All right. Let's try one where one of them is absolute value and one of them is not. Let's say we have a negative 17, and I'm comparing it to a 16. Well, there's nothing to worry about. 16 is still 16. But absolute value of a negative 17 is what? That's true. It is a positive 17. Positive 17. So it comes out as a positive, and I'm comparing it now to a 16, and 17 is greater than 16. So remember, when you are doing absolute value, you always bring the number out of the absolute value signs and make it positive. When you're comparing numbers that are in absolute value, bring them out first and then compare them.